Hello everyone, my name is Ma Long, Device Modeling Application Developer at Keysight Technologies. In this video, I would like to show you how to extract a BSIM4 DC model. Here is what we will be covering. We will start by introducing the BSIM4 model and its history. Then, we will go over a general model extraction flow, followed by measurement and geometry selection. At first, I will focus on the DC parameters extraction and then show you some tips to increase the productivity by introducing modeling utilities and MBP scripting to automate the process. Finally, we will show you how to access the project files used in this video, so you can take a deeper look, practice, and hopefully have fun with it. Before going through the detailed modeling process, let's jump to the finish line so you can see where we will end up. Our final model shows an excellent fit not only for the DC IV data across geometries, but also for the intermediate variable targets such as VTH, ID set, versus the gate length and width. Improvements on the accuracy has been achieved step by step, and in this video, I will be showing you how. The Berkeley Short Channel EGFET model, in short BSIM, is the physics-based compact model for bulk CMOS. It was developed by the BSIM research group at the University of California, Berkeley. As an extension of the BSIM3 model, BSIM4 has been used for the technology nodes from 0.13 micron down to 20 nanometers. Tons of improvements are made in BSIM4 to meet the challenges when the transistors become smaller and the advanced technologies are adopted. For example, the gate leakage current is modeled in BSIM4, while it's not covered by BSIM3. In 2000, BSIM4 was elected to become a compact model correlation CMOS standard and is now widely used across the industry. A complete modeling flow starts with test key design. After tape-out, on-wafer measurements are collected on various device geometries at different bias and temperatures. After CV and DC parameter extraction, we obtain the model card called best fitting. In this video, we will focus on the DC parameter extraction portion. The last four steps, recentering, corner modeling, library assembly, and the final QA will come later. All modeling efforts sit on a foundation of accurate measurement data. With not accurate data, one would be fitting wrong results, which will lead to big problems in circuit design and eventually the lab bench. On each device, what exactly do we need to measure? The answer is drain current ID, substrate current ISUB, and the gate current IG. IG is especially required when the gate oxide thickness is below 3 nanometer. We want the designer to leverage accurate models regardless of the device geometry, so we need to collect data across different geometries. As shown here, we have gate length ranging from L-min to L-max, and the gate width ranging from W-min to W-max. The W-max L-max device is used to extract model parameters which are independent of short and narrow channel effects and the parasitic resistance. I would recommend placing more gate length than width, since there are more model parameters that describe short channel effects than narrow channel effects. Using more devices does help to generate a more accurate model, but this also means more silicon area and longer measurement time. So, a trade-off needs to make here. Before we begin, it turns out that we do need some information from the foundry. Process parameters describe physical aspects of the device, like gate oxide thickness, source and drain junction depth, doping density, etc. From this table, you may get a feeling for the parameter names and what they represent. All of this information should be provided by the foundry process team before the model extraction. Flag parameters are like switches that turn on or turn off various equations. We show some examples of flag parameters here. Most flag parameters can be obtained by information provided by foundry. For example, in BSIM4, there are four sets of equations that could be used to describe mobility. Based on the setting of mode, we control which equation is proper to turn on for your process. Sometimes, based on which set of equations has been selected, new parameters are required to populate these equations. For a complex model such as BSIM4, it's easy to become overwhelmed by the large number of parameters and knowing what to model first. For beginners, I would suggest to run the automatic iteration flow first. This saves a lot of time in generating good models with reasonable accuracy. From a high-level perspective, you may customize the flow or run just a portion of the whole flow, for example, model parameter extraction only. In each step, we define a data region of interest, choose an optimizer, select model parameters and plots to be optimized. We begin with the largest device we have, with maximum gate width and length, and look at the linear region. By sweeping VGS, we observe the dependence of IDS to different VBS. In the region right, as the device turning on, we may extract VTR0, K1, and K2. On the other hand, in the linear region of IDS, we may get mu0, mu a, mu b, and mu c. From the equation below, you can see how some of these parameters are involved when calculating the effective mobility. MBP has a built-in spice engine, which allows you to check simulation results on the fly when tweaking model parameters. Next, using data from the same large device, we optimize the parameters V of, N factor, and CIT in the subthreshold region. To make the small drain current value visible to recognize, here we display the y-axis in log scale. If you are not very familiar with certain parameters, the parameter guide in MBP can provide you useful information about the parameter, such as the definition, default value, hard boundary, and the equations. From device physics, we know that the depletion region will not be uniform along the channel when a non-zero VDS is applied. This will cause VTH to vary along the channel. This effect is called bulk charge effect. BSIM4 uses A-bulk to model the bulk charge effect. Several model parameters are introduced to account for the channel length and width dependence and the bias effects. By taking the first derivative, we may convert the ID-VD plot to a GDS-VD plot. The parameters PDC1, PDC2, and PDCB are used to correct the drain-induced barrier lowering Debye effect in strong inversion. You can add pins to the points that you select so as to display their simulation, measurement, or the fitting error values in the plot. Now, we move to look at the IO-ready devices with the fixed W marks. In the graph on the upper left, we see the relationship between threshold voltage VTH and the length of the channel L at VBS equals 0 only. This curve describing the short channel effect is captured using the parameters DVT0, DVT1, and LLPE0. Next, in the graph at the lower right, we see the body bias dependence as VBS ranges from 0 to -1.5 V. Here are the model parameters used to capture this dependence. The Equation Viewer tool in MBP can help you debug model issues and thereby improve model quality. For example, by looking at the equation for VTH, now we have a better understanding how VTH is calculated for the selected operating points. In the previous slides, we studied short channel effects and their effects on threshold voltage. VTH is referred to as an intermediate variable, or IMV in MBP. Using the script within MBP, we can define algorithms to calculate IMV and add new IMV plots as required in your extraction flows. MBP Script is based on Java and supports most of Java expressions. We can use the script language to transform data, define plots, run optimization, and customize extraction flow. For example, I first create an IMV named VTHGM. Once the IMV is defined, I continue to create its IMV plots. For example, VTH versus L as shown here. In addition, an error table plot can be created with script to check fitting accuracy in a global view. We will provide this script for you to download in the end of the video. Moving forward on the extraction flow, we continue to extract other model parameters related to WRE with fixed gate length but varying gate width. Then, we look at small devices and the corner devices respectively. Several iterations on the model parameters may be needed. Model fitting always requires trade-off, since you will never find the perfect model for a real device. Your goal is to make the model fit the data for as many geometries as possible. You will weigh the geometries and or targets which are important to your circuit design, possibly at the expense of others. Besides, get a good fit for the IV plots and IMV targets. It's also important to ensure the trend of your IMV plots are consistent with the measured data. In this short video, I introduce a general DC modeling extraction flow for the BSIM4 model, which is one of the most popular models used in the industry today. Generating a good fitting model definitely needs experience. I have tried to show you some of the basics and a few shortcuts. I have also provided the example files that can help you get a jump start. The program I used was Model Builder Program, MBP, and you can download the example files by clicking the link in the text description associated with this video, or by directly using the URL link shown here. Thanks for your time and happy modeling.